Hey there, it's Kaylee. We're going to learn about the distributive property over subtraction. Make sure you've already completed the lesson called distributive property over addition before getting started on this one. Let's get right to it. So let's get started with an example. This one says, evaluate 5 times 20 minus 5. Why don't you go ahead and try this on your own first? Pause the video here and give it a go. Nice, so now I'm gonna work this problem out 2 ways. First, I'm going to use order of operations. So if I use my order of operations, I will have 5 times 20 minus 5. And I do what's in the parentheses first, right? So this subtraction, so I'll have 5 times 20 minus 5 is 15. And when I multiply this out, what do I get? Yeah, 75 is my answer. But we know another way of solving this type of problem. We can use the distributive property. So I'm going to rewrite my expression over here. I have 5 times 20 minus 5. And when I use the distributive property, what do? Yeah, I take what's outside the parentheses and I distribute it to everything inside the parentheses. So I will have 5 times 20 minus 5 times 5. Now, if I do my multiplication, 5 times 20, that gives me 100 minus 5 times 5, that gives me 25. And now if I do my subtraction, I will get 75. Perfect. Our answers here are matching. So when we use both methods, order of operations like we did over here, and the distributive property like we did right here, this will confirm that our distributive property works and gives us the correct answer. So here's one more example. It says evaluate 2 times 8 minus 3 minus 2 using the distributive property. So right away, I know that I am not using order of operations. I can go straight to distributing what is outside my parentheses to what is inside my parentheses. But let's rewrite this first to cozy up our 2 and our parentheses so it's really clear. Remember, this bullet here just means multiplication, so I can just write this 2 right next to the parentheses, and it'll look like 2 times 8 minus 3 minus 2. So here I go with my distributive property. Remember, I take my 2, and I'm going to multiply it by what? Yeah, everything inside the parentheses, so even this third term in here. So I'll have 2 times 8 minus 2 times 3 minus 2 times 2. And now I can go through my multiplication, 2 times 8, that'll give me 16 minus 2 times 3 is 6 minus 2 times 2, which is 4. And now I can do my subtraction, 16 minus 6, that'll leave me with 10 minus 4, and 10 minus 4 is 6. So that's the answer to our expression using the distributive property. Good job. You're ready to practice using the distributive property over subtraction on your own. After you do some practice, we'll learn why the distributive property is super important. Our next video is about using the distributive property with variables. I'll see you there. Hey.